Transfers part 2. In this video, in part 2 of this video, I'm going to take you through a transfer template. So I'm going to show you how to create a template for a transfer that you're going to do on a regular basis, and so then you have that easy reference of applying that template for that transfer. So we need to click on our drop down menu and select transfer templates. Once here, we can go up to the toolbar and click new because we want to create a new template. We can type in the name of the template. So for this example, it's going to be our end of day cash transfer to bank. When you hit tab or click down to the next field, the description self-populates, but you can add maybe a little bit more detail here if you wanted to. So let's say that this is our US cash and RBC bank. Now you can tab down or click into the transfer amount field. You can enter in the amount if you know that it's going to be a regular same amount transfer, or you can leave it blank. That's fine. So, but we're going to put in 5,000 for this example, and our currency you can put in if you know, or you've got some quick easy buttons of some popular currencies right here. Now we need to select the transfer account from. So you can click into the field or tab down. And let's say it's from our cash account and into which account. So click on the field and we are going to find the RBC banks. And now we can just click save. So you see that we now have a transfer template completed. And once you have that all saved, we can use the toolbar across the top to make edits and deletes to any of our templates. So I can select this one and I can now go back in and edit it and say, actually, this is not, it's going to be a regular recurrence of 6,000, so let's change that. And then we can just click save, or we can actually, in fact, delete these transfer templates from this screen as well. So what does this look like when I want to apply a template into a transfer that I'm doing in my invoices? So let's have a look. In our module for invoices, let's go up to the toolbar and click on new. And like I showed in part 1 video, you go to your transfer button or you can click Control or Command T. And instead of filling in the information like we did before, you can select this button down below, Pick from Template. Now, if you had many templates, you can search by typing it in, or as we only have the one template right now in this example, we can just select it here. If there isn't a template and you wanted to create a new one, we can actually do that from this screen as well. We can select the button New Template and then create a new template that will be saved going forward. But for now, we've selected the one we've created and we're going to click Pick. You'll see that it's all pulled through onto this screen now. And you can actually make a few changes as well. So we can change the amount if for some reason this isn't the amount we wanted to use, or that we left that amount blank in our template. Now you may have noticed on the template you couldn't actually put in any date ranges, any transfer dates or any deposit dates. That you will always have to do on this screen. So we can put in the date for the 28th, and let's just leave it at the 28th for the bank as well. We now need to add our reference number because that's not going to be the same for every single one, so the template will not save that. And we can change some notes and remarks if we need to, or it will just pull through what the title was of that transfer template. And now we can click save, and it will bring those line items through. And once again, we can click save again and close. And you'll see that we've now done a transfer with our template.